Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Avery, and here are all of the books that I will hopefully be getting to this summer. So the spring semester at my university just ended a couple days ago, and so I am here in my parents' house, and I took all of the books that I plan on reading this summer with me. The books in this video are all physical reads. I obviously have books that I plan to read this summer that are not just physically own. But for the sake of this video, these are all of the physical books that I own that I took with me to my parents' house where I will be staying for the next 3 months. So I thought that I would tell you first all of the books that have been on my May TBR that's already been posted. I'll fly right through those since y'all probably already know what those books are. First we have Sorcery of Thorns by Margaret Rogerson. This was my TBR jar pick for the month of April, but I ended up not getting to it because of the craziness of school and the Libby audio wait is still a couple weeks away. And people have told me how amazing the audiobook is, so I really wanted to listen to the audiobook, but I have to wait for it to come in. So I brought my physical copy with me because I will hopefully be reading it in May, and if not May, if I don't get the audiobook in May, then I'll read it in June. But this is a young adult fantasy novel dealing with a magical library, which sounds amazing to me. We then have my May TBR jar pick, which is Upside Down by Leah Riley. This will be a reread for me, but I honestly remember nothing about this book, so that's why I put it in my TBR jar. This is a romance book that takes place in Australia. Our heroine, she is a college student, and she does a study abroad in Australia, and there she meets our hero, who is a surfer dude. I remember really enjoying this when I first read it, but I could not tell you anything about this book now. That's the only thing I know about it, is that it takes place in Australia and there's this guy that surfs, and that's all that I know. So be prepared for me to vlog this, and I might even add the next two books in the series into that vlog. Let me know if you want just the first book for me to vlog about it, or the next two. I think this one is the next one, and then this one is the last one. Sideswiped and Inside Out. These are the next two in the series. This is a trilogy about the same couple. So I brought the rest of the series with me because I will be reading this in May, this one in May. And then the only reason why I put this in my TBR jar was so that I could get to the rest of the series, because I have both of the other two books and I haven't read them yet, but I have to read the first one to get reacquainted with the story and everything. So I brought these three with me in hopes of completing this trilogy. And the last book in this video that was a part of my May TBR is Lie Down in Roses by Shannon Drake. I absolutely adore this cover. It is stunning. That's the main reason why I picked it up, obviously. This is a historical romance. This is a romance where our heroine is out to kill the hero, but she falls in love with him instead. So I love that trope so stinking much. So I have high hopes for this one. Then back there, I had a bucket of mass markets that I brought with me. So I'm gonna share with you the mass markets that I brought with me. First, I have Trust in Me by Jennifer L. Armentrout. Wait for You by Jennifer L. Armentrout is one of my favorite books ever. I connect to that story so immensely. So this is Wait for You, her book, but in the perspective of the hero Cam. So this is a college new adult romance where our heroine Avery is escaping her hometown, goes to school across the country to escape the horrible life that she had in her hometown, and she's hiding some secrets and some trauma that she went through, and there she meets soccer superstar Cam, who really likes her and wants to get to know her more, and but she keeps pushing him away. So we never got Cam's perspective in that book, but this is the book all in Cam's point of view. So I brought this one with me in case I'm in the mood to read this one. I haven't gotten to it in a very long time, but I don't know. Summer may just be it for me to pick this up finally. I am then working my way through the Spindle Cove series by Tessa Dare, so I brought the fifth book in the series, which is Do You Want to Start a Scandal? I will be getting to this one soon. I have the fourth book on hold currently, and I'm about to listen to it, so this one will be up very, very soon. This is a historical romance. Here is the very pretty, cute Step Back. I love her dress so much. All these dresses in these historical romance step backs and covers are just like everything that I want. I'm a dress person. I love dresses so much, and so I want this dress. But I don't know anything about this book, and I'm not gonna read the summary because it's a part of a series. I then have Border Bride by Amanda Scott. This one just looks so much fun. Like, look, the couple on here is also raised along with the lettering, and it's just gorgeous. I believe this is a Scottish romance, and she claims that he's a barbarian. I love those two things, a Scottish hero and barbarian, so I hope that this one's amazing. I haven't heard anybody talk about this book, so Hopefully this is a historical that I can get other people on board with. Then we have For the Roses by Julie Garwood. I haven't read any Julie Garwood, so I just brought this book if I'm in a historical mood, and people love Julie Garwood, so I just brought this one. Then we have The Lily and the Sword by Sarah Bennett. This was in my most recent book haul, and it just sounds so good. This is a romance between a woman and the man who has been sent to hunt her. That sounds so good. I really want to read this as soon as possible. Another book that was a part of my most recent book haul was Her Texas Cowboy by Jill Lynn. I believe this is a Harlequin novel, right? It just looks really summery and cute, so I thought it would be perfect for this time of year. And this takes place in Texas. I live in Texas, so I hopefully will like this one. The only Harlequin that I've read I did not enjoy, so I'm hoping that this one redeems Harlequins for me. And then the last mass market that I have for you is Lord of the Fading Lands by C.L. Wilson. In my most recent book haul, almost everyone was commenting how good this book was. And if I'm in the fantasy romance mood, I'm picking this one up, y'all. People have been raving about this one. I love The Winter King by C.L. Wilson, so hopefully I love this one as well. Okay, on to the rest of the books that I brought with me. Then we have Unbroken 13 Stories Starring Disabled Teens by an anthology of authors. This is a young adult book. I started this book during one of the buzzword readathons 2 years ago. It's been on my currently reading shelf on Goodreads for over 2 years. This was the buzzwordathon dealing with numbers because it's 13 stories starring disabled teens. I have read up to where this bookmark is, and I'm probably going to reread them. If not, I will look back at them. What I did for the stories that I did read is I did a little summary sticky note. I do that a lot with my required readings in schools, so I am very happy with myself that I did that, so I can refresh myself now. But yeah, I'm only this far of the way through it. Look how pretty this is though. Like, look, this looks gorgeous. As someone who does have a disability, I definitely want to read more books that have disability representation in it. I honestly don't remember the stories that were in here. I remember not really enjoying the first one, and I think that's maybe what set me off for the rest of the book. I didn't really enjoy the first one, so maybe I'll just go revisit some of the other ones that I've already read and refresh my memory, and then get on and read the rest of the book, because I finally want to get this off of my currently reading shelf on Goodreads. I just want to read more books that star disabled teens, so. Yeah. Then we have a book I plan to be reading any day now, which is Nimona by Noelle Stevenson. This is a graphic novel, and one of my very, very, very best friends lent this to me last summer, and I still haven't gotten to it. She's been borrowing a lot of books from me recently. She's currently reading the A Quarter of Thorns and Roses series for the first time, the first book in the series, and so she let me borrow one of her books, and we've been trading graphic novels too. I got her to read Pumpkinheads and I think Saga, and so she gave me this one to read, and I've had it for so long and I feel horrible, and I really want to read it. She raves about this one and loves this one. All I know is that it's a graphic novel. That's all I'm gonna know about it. I'm just gonna go in completely blind and have fun. I have to read this one very soon because I'm going to see her in a couple of weeks, so I gotta get this one as soon as possible. Look who's coming to greet us. Hello. Oh, do you want to be in the video? Oh, she's gonna just plop right down. There we go. The next book that I'm going to be talking about is Thanks for Last Night by three authors, Eve Langlais, Millie Tatin, and Kate Baxter. This was in my most recent book haul, and this is a book filled with three short stories about shifters of some sort. Oh, do you like it? No? These are, I think, all bear shifters, maybe. I don't know, there's a bear on the cover, so I assume all of them might be bear shifters. If not, they're all shifters of some sort. I love shifter books. I've been in the huge shifter mood, so I brought this one with me. I'm trying to read all of Christina Loren's backlist, so I brought Love in Other Words. This one is a very beloved one on BookTube and in the book community in general. This is a friends to lovers romance, and that's all I know about it. I'm gonna go into it completely blind. I love Christina Loren's books, and this is more of their earlier works, and so I'm hoping for just amazing read, because their more recent books haven't really been my jive, you know? Then I have the two Alyssa Cole books that were in my previous book haul. First we have Be Not Afraid and Let Us Dream. These are just short, like, little novellas that I found at a bookstore one time, and like, they're fast, quick reads. Oh, what are you talking to me? You talking to me? I feel like summer is the time to just like fly through books that you really want to read. So these are two books that I really want to read, and I want to read more Alyssa Cole. Then I have The Summer I Found You by Jolene Perry. This has been on many TBRs, and I've been meaning to get to it for a while. All I know about this book is that it is a romance that deals with a character who I believe has type 2 diabetes. As I said before, I love books that have disability rep in them, and I definitely want to read more, and so hopefully this can be one that I can recommend to everyone else. On the topic of disability rep, we have Only When It's Us by Chloe Lise. I got this one for Christmas from my lovely friend Morgan from Nothing Better Than a Book. So thank you so much, Morgan. She talks about this book so much and I've been meaning to read it for forever. And I haven't found the time, or like the audiobook lapses over and I can't get to it. But like, this book sounds so good. I believe she is a soccer player and he is deaf and they're in the same college class. And I've just heard amazing things about this book, the series in general, and I want to get on the bandwagon because every book I believe has some sort of disability rep in there. And I love that. Then I have Phoenix Unbound by Grace Draven. I'm trying to read all of Grace Draven's backlist by the end of the year, so I brought this one with me. This is the only physical copy that I own by her that I have not read yet. This is a fantasy romance dealing with witchcraft of some sort. I don't wanna go too much into it. I like to go into her books completely blind and have her surprise me, but just look how stunning this cover is. I adore it. I also have the second one on audio on Libby available for me to download whenever I want to, and so whenever I finish this one, I will definitely dive into book two. I don't own it physically though. Then we have another book from that book haul that was just posted, which is Queen of Swords by Katie Robert. This is a sci-fi romance that Katie Robert wrote, and that sounds so good to me. I have been on such the sci-fi kick, the alien romance kick, so I brought this one with me and I will hopefully be getting to it very soon. This just sounds amazing, and I had no idea that Katie Robert wrote sci-fi books before I found this at my local bookstore. Next, I have Love on Beach Avenue by Jennifer Probst. So this is a best friend's brother romance where I believe it's enemies to lovers of some sort, and her best friend is getting married, so there's like a wedding aspect of this book, which I love in books. This one just I felt like was perfect for summertime because look at the beach and the cover. Super summery to me. Next, we have Escape With Me by Kristen Proby. This one is about Isabella, and she walks into Keegan's bar one night in a wedding dress. So she just left her wedding, and apparently it's a romance between the two of them. So I'm very excited to see how that's gonna work out. I'm wanting to read more and different authors this summer, so I brought this one because I've never read a book by Kristen Proby before. Then we have Most Eligible Billionaire by Annika Martin. I brought this one with me because it just sounded so cute. Oh, you like this one? You like this one? It just sounded so sweet and cute because this is a romance about a woman and a man. The woman inherited her neighbor who just died, her dog. And that woman left like a $1 million company to the dog. And apparently the woman who like inherits the dog, she like goes to the company or whatever to see what's going on. And it's her romance with the CEO of that company who is not amused at all that the dog owns the company. So that sounded so sweet and cute. And I feel like summer is the perfect time for cute reads. So I'm very much looking forward to this. And I want to see how a dog can get a company. Then we have a book that was recently sent to me by Valentine PR. So thank you so much, Valentine PR, for sending me Back in the Burbs by Tracy Wolf and Avery Flynn. I have loved Avery Flynn's books. In the past, I've read her, I think it's the Hardigans series. I really liked that series. And I've yet to read a book by Tracy Wolf, even though I've heard amazing things about her. Some of my BookTube friends have been reading this recently and really enjoy it. So I'm very much looking forward to this one. And lastly on this list is probably the one that a lot of people want me to read. And that is From Blood and Ash by Jennifer L. Armentrout. This one is a hunky doozy, thick chick book. This is a fantasy romance. And that's all I know about it. Fantasy romance that has taken the internet by storm. I've heard from many people that they adore the series. I've also heard from many people that they do not like the series and that it is way overhyped and not that good. I wanna know my thoughts about it. I was thinking this summer on filming a dedicated reading vlog for this book. Let me know if you're interested in that. But yeah, this is a fantasy romance that everyone has read but me, apparently. And I'll hopefully be getting to it in the next couple months. So for my upcoming monthly TBR videos, they're going to be quite different than what I normally do, because I normally have my giant jar that I have with me back at my apartment, back in my college town. I did not bring that with me because I might pull a book that I did not bring with me physically. So I'm going to be making a whole entire new little jar just filled with the books that I did bring with me here to pick from once a month. So expect that in future TBR videos. But that's it. Those are all of the physical books that I ended up bringing to my parents' house over the summer. And I will hopefully be getting to all of them in the next 3 months. I want to read all of them. I want to read more physical books on my shelf. I feel like that's why I brought so many with me, is because I want to get that physical TBR down. Please let me know down below if you have read any of these books, or if you plan to, or if you'd love to buddy read one of these books with me. Please DM me on Instagram. I'd love to chat with you. But anyways, thank y'all so, so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.